yo, travel day, Ho Chi Minh to Hanoi, packed up, saying goodbye to my really comfy room that I've absolutely loved staying in. This bed is so comfortable. Oh my God. I'm gonna miss it a lot. But yeah, heading to the airport now. I need to go walk 8 minutes, then get a bus. Bus takes me straight to the airport. Flight's in like three, well, by the time I get there, I'll be in 3 hours. And we're gonna probably get some food at the airport. There you go. Okay, that was a fucking nightmare to get through the airport. When I booked my flight online, it auto-filled, and I did actually pay attention to the fact it didn't include my middle names in the booking. So when I got to the check-in, they were like, this isn't you. I was like, that is me. I didn't look at the passport. And they were like, there's two names missing. And I had to explain they're my fucking middle names, and then I ended up going to a counter and ended up paying an extra $5 for them to change the booking name. Oh, and then I went back to the thing to check in, and then they told me that my tripod couldn't come through, so I then strapped my tripod to my check-in bag. But then he wouldn't accept that, so then I put my rain cover over my bag to make it look like an actual bag. And then for whatever reason, that meant he could check it, even though the rain cover's got ripped in it. And then he wanted to weigh this bag, and you can get 7 kg per person, and this one was like 14. This was really heavy. So I like put it on the scales and I was like holding it. And he was like, oh, it's a little bit overweight. And I was like, oh, okay. And then like I took it off. And he was like, oh, can you, he then stuck the label on, gave me my passport open. He was like, oh, can you weigh your bag? And I was like, no, it's okay. And put my bag on, walked off. So, but I'm through security now. Fingers crossed we get to Hanoi without any more issues. Because Jesus Christ. I've got a headache. I'm still kind of ill. I just didn't need this today. I think the best part about domestic flights is not having to go for security, because we got off the plane up there, down the escalators, and I'm already at baggage. Grab a bag and I leave. So much easier than going through all the security. Although, because it's so fast, we've now got to wait for the baggage to get off the plane. So there is that side of it, but still, it's easier. Bus headed to the hostel. You know what, for the last maybe week or two, I think I've been going through a bit of a creative burnout without really realizing I was going through it. I was putting a lot of pressure on myself to create, which if you've had a creative burnout, you know that's the worst thing you can do. It just amplifies and makes it all worse. However, I can tell that I'm coming out the other side of it now, because I've been walking for about 10 minutes from the bus station down to my hostel, and I'm seeing photo opportunity after photo opportunity after photo opportunity. I am so excited to come back down this walk with camera in hand, probably the 50 mil on, and just snap away, because I'm gonna get some banger photos and I can't wait. Hostel's another like 5 minutes this way. I can go check in and get these bags off me. I've always said, put me in a city with my camera and I can entertain myself for hours. It's been about 20 minutes of walking from my hostel. I'm just wandering around Hanoi and I'm having loads of fun. Creative burnout has most definitely passed. I'm feeling good today, I'm feeling creative. I'm getting some banger photos. Travel burnout is still passing, and I'll talk about that in a minute. There was this letter I read. If you like pina colada, and life gives you lemons. Made vodka lemonade. Embrace the fucking rain. Embrace the moment for what it is. Because guess what? I'm caught in the rain in the middle of Vietnam. But at least I'm not sat inside an office job hating my fucking life, watching rain drip down the window. And that's a fucking mood.
Okay, I am about to go on a walking food tour around Hanoi.
While I wait to get picked up for this walking food tour, I want to quickly talk about the travel burnout I mentioned earlier. I'm sure most creatives are familiar with creative burnout. There's not exactly a set cause for it, it just sort of happens. What a lot of people might not realise is the exact same thing can happen with travel.
constantly getting more things done, constantly doing these new experiences without taking any time to rest like you normally would at home can cause a burnout. And I think that's what I caused for myself in my time in Bali. I basically didn't stop. The days that I thought I was stopping and I was resting, I'd end up going out partying, or I'd end up spending the day doing work, or I was constantly doing something. I didn't take any time to just sit down and do nothing. The only time I did that was when I got ill in Lombok, and I took a couple of days. And from then, I was starting to show signs of creative burnout, and I was stressing myself out because I was overthinking it, that I need to get content done, I need to work, I need to make more. And so I never actually let myself relax and rest. And when I got to Ho Chi Minh, I managed to actually do that. I took a few days, mainly because I was ill again, but I took a few days to recover and literally spent almost an entire day just in bed, just doing nothing, just chilling out. And it was so needed for me. The last few days, I've been doing work, but I've been doing it at a much more sustainable pace. I've done a few hours of work, a few hours exploring, a few hours of relaxing, and I'm pacing myself with everything a lot more, and it's working a lot better so far. So if you didn't realize that travel burnout was a thing, it is. And if you start to experience it, it's the same as any other burnout. You need to take a step back and just stop, relax, reset, and stop putting stress and pressure on yourself. With that being said, let's go on a walking food tour. Something I didn't actually know was happening until right now is the Hanoi Night Market, which is where I'm at now. There's a street that gets completely shut off straight through the old quarter of Hanoi, and it's all turned into a night market. They set up stalls all the way down, and they are selling everything from fake supreme to clothes to jewelry, which I can't tell if it's real silver or not because it seems a bit too cheap, but then again, it is Asia, so who knows. To tripods, to phone accessories, to absolutely anything, to fake Air Force, like everything you could want, they're selling it down the street. So this happens only on Friday nights. It's a very cool thing. I've been walking up and down, bought a new earring. It's not the one I'm wearing, but fuck it, I bought a new earring because it was like 94p. I've been looking for a black version of this anyway. Fake wallets. I'm guessing, that's not real Christian Dior, is it? So let me quickly tell you about that food walking tour. So it's not quite what I was expecting. I was expecting a group tour. It was literally a local student will come and meet you and they will recommend places for you to eat. It's completely free, but you do pay for their dinner as well. You effectively pay twice as much for the food than you would, but you're getting a free tour. Great guide. From talking to my guide, she explained that they actually do it because they're students and it means they can practice their English. So it's really cool. It's very mutually beneficial. She recommended some absolutely great places to eat. The first thing we ate was really nice. Then we had some pho, I know how to say that one. That was really good. And then we went for egg coffee, which is literally, they crack an egg and then they pour coffee and condensed milk on top and you mix up. And it's a lot thicker than I was expecting, but it's actually really nice. The cafe we went to have that is actually the origin place of egg coffee. It's the first place they ever made it in Vietnam. So that was really cool. So I highly recommend that. There's a few different companies that operate that, but this was my one. You can message them on Facebook or online. What? Really cool. I highly recommend it.
What's this?
This is phone.
What? Turn it, this phone.
It's a vlog.
It's a camera.
It's my phone.
Yes?
I'm making a vlog.
Staring on a camera.
Yes.
Sure. Yes. Maybe. So, let me watch this.
I'm talking to the camera.
I'm talking to the camera.
So go on YouTube.
Yes?
Yes. Do you want to be in my video?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Mind the bike. Oh, there we go.
Wow.
Yeah. All right. But I have now made a friend. Pardon?
Yes.
Yeah, the speakers.
Standing on the camera.
Yeah. Yeah.
Standing on the camera.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, I'd really recommend the walking tour, basically. This has happened. I'm going to end this vlog here. Do you want to say bye? I'm going to end my video.
Bye. Yeah? Just like it on the video.
Like it, yeah? Like the video and subscribe.
And subscribe.
Exactly that.
Yeah.
See you next one. See ya.
See you later.